Welcome back, yo. Like, subscribe, tell all your friends.
There's so much to learn. So much to learn.
I'm ready to learn more bard now.
Good.
Yes.
Now, this spell comes with a caveat. It should only be used when necessary. The exploding charm, as you might suspect, can hurt people. Use caution when casting it.
I will, Professor.
I will hold you to that promise. Now, you must be precise in your wand movements. We don't want you blowing your hand off. Go ahead. Nice and steady wand movements. Remember, the exploding charm is highly volatile.
Professor, might I have a moment?
Yes. What is it?
I was wondering what inspired your interest in magical beasts.
Are you considering some sort of profession in the field?
I haven't decided quite yet, but I do find magical beasts fascinating.
You do seem to engage well with the beasts in class. I believe that when choosing a path, particularly of a scholarly nature, one must take into account both one's enthusiasm for a particular subject, as well as how one may best serve the students to whom one is obligated to both inspire and teach.
Of course, Professor. When did your path become clear?
I recall it quite vividly. It was the summer between my 6th and 7th years. I read in the Prophet about a wizard who'd been selling alchemy eggs and disappeared in the mountains near my home. I knew of the alchemy, of course, from my studies, but they are native to lands east of here, such as India. I wondered if it was possible that an alchemy could be so nearby. Hence, I went to find it.
Seems quite a challenge finding an alchemy in the mountains.
It was. After a few days, during which my parents grew increasingly annoyed at my absence, I found what little remained of the wizard egg trader. He was near a tree hollow, and there, inside, was a nest with 7 silver alchemy eggs.
What did you do with them?
Nothing. Beasts are to be valued for what they can provide for wizard kind. Protective clothing, potion ingredients, even one course. Only poachers see the value in ending a beast's life for galleons. I left the eggs alone. I hid. And moments later, the beast flew right over my head. Breathtaking. She then seemed to all but disappear as she shrunk to fit into the hollow.
That sounds incredible.
Indeed. I knew in that moment that I needed to understand all that I could about beasts and ensure that wizardkind learned to benefit properly from them. Now, I trust that I have answered your question. You would do well to continue your study of beasts, regardless of your chosen path. Beasts and all that they provide will vastly improve your life, and perhaps one day even save it.
I shall remember that, Professor. Thank you.
Sorry, y'all. I was watching Trail Inferno. He's playing a fight and shit.
I'd like to shop in the hallway.
Let's see. I haven't been this shit in a while. So what do I do now? Oh, man. Get there. Sorry, all this game sucks for loading screens.
likely this astronomy table will be best used when it's dark. Here's one of those tables Professor Shaw mentioned. Lumos. Re- Repeating. Lumos. Highwing's fine. I'm keeping an eye on her. She's safe, Poppy, I promise.
Good. Whatever the poachers are up to, I want Highwing far from it.
You said you had news about the poachers, and that some of it has to do with me.
It did. I overheard them talking in the Hogshead, and did you know that they have orders from Victor Rookwood to capture you on sight? Does it have anything to do with Rookwood and Harlow coming for you in the Three Broomsticks after the troll attack?
It does, somewhat. But at the moment, I'm more concerned about what else you heard the poachers are up to.
Fair enough. But I hope you'll let me know if I can be of help, especially after what you did for Highwing. Does the name Haunter Hall mean anything to you?
I'm afraid not. Why? What is it?
The poachers' best kept secret, apparently. The name came up twice, but they never went into detail. I also overheard one of them bragging about all the gold they're making, at the expense of innocent creatures, undoubtedly. The poachers spoke of this area, and I thought if we searched around a bit, it might give us clues as to what they're doing. If you ever meet my gran, this trip never happened.
Not to worry, Poppy. If I ever meet your gran, I shall not speak a word of this.
I normally tell her everything. She might be my best friend after Halloween, but she knows how I feel about the poachers. I think she worries I'll do something ill-advised.
What happened to the last idea?
This way.
Do you take us for fools? That we do not notice more and more of your kind around here, in league with the poachers?
We aren't involved with them. If anything, we want to see them stopped.
I hope for your sake that is true. Our kind is swiftly losing patience with the poachers and those they work with.
I should beg you to go. We're gonna tear them up. Jesus got the lesson. Come, we work for PETA. Oh shit, come on, Poppy. She's so slow. Come on, baby, so slow. Come on.
He was certainly a chopper.
That could have gone worse. Centaurs aren't exactly fans. And the poachers aren't helping matters.
But why would he think that we had anything to do with poachers?
I did notice the poachers talking with a few villagers in Hogsmeade. I'm not sure why. Perhaps that's why the centaurs are suspicious.
It seems that a lot of the beasts have been more aggressive than usual lately.
I've noticed that too. It's almost like there's something in the water. This is odd.
What is it?
Not entirely sure, but look around. If the poachers were here, perhaps we can find out why.
Here to poach. Well, what else they be here for? Come on, girl.
Best why wouldn't they take their cages with them when they left?
Because they got the ass whooped for poaching. We are PETA. We're here to save. Not really.
Pounce. Poor beasts.
Trying to stay warm. It's cold outside.
Not still smoking.
Still
they can't be cold enough.
All this shit is trash.
Rebellion. This is golden metal. Seems to have a place in a poacher camp.
No, because the goblin.
I should tell Poppy about it.
So tell Poppy.
Anything interesting?
Yeah, goblins.
Poachers were here. All sorts of evidence. But I found something else. It's goblin made.
I found goblin! Let's keep searching, but carefully.
Fucking goblins, man.
Merlin only knows what's going on here. I don't have a good feeling about this.
Should you have? Come on, girl. You're out hunting poachers.
How did Goblin and Poachers
interest align? No, it's not even around. You just walk so slow. Come on, run, Poppy, run. Use those legs.
Look, down there.
Definitely Poachers.
Both are Poachers.
New creatures, though. So what are they doing out here?
Let's take a closer look.
They won't be happy to see us. Should we use disillusionment? Or perhaps a less discreet approach?
Hard to say from up here. Let's get a better lay of the land.
Come on, Poppy. Poppy, come on.
We want to look at us, that's it. No fool. Who looks at the likes of us and thinks we're after cauldron cake?
course, it's very lucky that... I've never heard such quiet in all my life. I think I get more sense out of Bloomcalf done. Around Felcroft for something to poach.
Ranrock and the poachers must be working together.
Oh, something's going on behind you.
What's going on down there?
Let's make them count. Ready.
Yeah.
I'm guessing here we have belongs to that dragon.
I don't think she knew they had her egg. She wouldn't have left without it.
What now? She didn't exactly leave us a call on the card.
I don't know. Nothing about this day was expected. Not the goblins, and definitely not the fighting ring. The last thing I planned on was a dragon egg. And the poachers saw us, which cannot be good.
We aren't helping ourselves standing here. Let's get to safety. We can sort this out later.
You're right. If anything the poachers are good at, it's tracking their prey. And right now, we're it. Be careful, won't you? I shall see you back at the castle.
Rebellion.
is almost too easy.
Thank you.
isn't it? Yeah. So this is the underground harbor.
Ready!
The Grey Lady. I'd say hello, but she doesn't seem particularly social. Well, on to go.
the fuck?
Well, on to go.
It's a relief to finally have an answer for Wyatt.
Professor Weasley asked me to find it. Should be around here somewhere.
Looking for the book Intermediate Transfiguration.
Professor Weasley asked me to get something from that book. May I have it?
Did she now? I'll give you this book if you humor me by answering a few questions on my quiz.
Quiz?
Some people call bits of knowledge trivia. I would argue that no knowledge is trivial. Hence, I have created a small quiz, just for fun, focusing mainly on the lore of the Wizarding World. None of the other students will try it, no matter how many times I ask. They all say they have enough with schoolwork. Ugh, they don't value knowledge the way I do. Surely you're interested. I'll even start you off with a few of my easiest questions.
A quiz sounds like fun.
Splendid! Just a few questions and then I'll hand over this book. Let us begin. Before the invention of the golden snitch, which magical creature was used in the game of Quidditch?
Which Founder's relics?
No. The answer was the Deathly Hallows. According to Beedle the Bard, the Deathly Hallows consist of the Elder Wand, the Resurrection Stone, and the Cloak of Invisibility. Which ball in Quidditch is the largest?
The Quaffle.
That's right. When a chaser throws the Quaffle through one of three hoops in a Quidditch match, their team is awarded 10 points. True or false? Polyjuice Potion allows the drinkers to change species.
I'm gonna feed the cats and pet them.
Settle down! Transfiguration eyesight. Now, you all know what to do. Class is dismissed. And remember, now is not the time to ease off your studies.
Rebellion.
Those W. Wells will be here before you know it.
You wanted to discuss my progress so far this time, Professor.
I did. You seem to have had no trouble in getting up to speed, and frankly, excelling in your schoolwork this year.
Thank you, Professor. The extra assignments have been helpful.
As I suspected they would be. Now, it seems you've been making good use of the opportunities presented by your field guide. Of course, the guide isn't the only measure of success. I've heard that you can brew an impressive Edurus potion. Hopefully, you won't need it anytime soon, but it is a valuable potion to have when it is needed.
Thank you, Professor.
I will say I'm especially impressed with all you've accomplished in light of the rumors of your extracurricular activities. Was your visit to the kitchens and the Hogsmeade graveyard with Nick to bribe a ghost for information connected in any way to Professor Fig?
Not at all. I'm fascinated by ghosts and food, and I was interested in learning more about the castle and surrounding area.
I see. I admire your penchant for learning, but do remember that your classwork and field guide are designed to educate you thoroughly. It'll be the end of the year in no time, and you'll want to be well prepared for your OWLs. I'll provide a final assessment at that time to ensure that you're ready for your exams. Until then, well done. You're dismissed. If you wish to practice the spell you just learned, the training drumming is available. Glad to see you paying close attention to my demonstration of the transformation
spell.
Morgoth!
Since our visit to Felcroft, something dawned on me about the ship. Near the overlook, just north of the village.
speaks gobbledygook.
Gobbledygook?
I remember I mentioned something about gobbledygook.
Gobbledygooks? Gobbledygooks? Man, I gotta sell some of these pets, man. Oh, people in the market. Giant purple toad, I can go release him to my little house. That's what's up. Ooh, what did it say?
Deke would like to talk with you when you have a moment.
Thank you.
out here.
Thank you.
Deke would like to talk with you when you have a moment. To talk with you when you have a moment. Deke's no herbology professor, but some plants have a Deke.
Professor Weasley said you wanted to tell me more about the loom.
Yes, about that. Deke has had a thought. He could... clothing that you enhanced in the enchanted loom. And perhaps help an old friend in the process.
What do you mean?
A house elf named Tobbs works for his master, retrieving leech juice in a cave near Hogwarts. Tobbs' master doesn't let him leave the cave, and he knows the cave is infested with spiders.
That sounds awful.
It is. Deke hasn't heard from his friend for a while now. As the item you wove in the loom has an enchantment that might be useful, Deke thought you could test it whilst checking on Tobbs.
I understand. Leave it to me, Deke. I'll find Tobbs for you.
Oh, thank you. Please let Deke know what you learn about Deke's old friend.
Thank you.
things. You should be proud of all the potions you brewed.
What did you need me to do, Deke?
Deke's friend, Tubbs, collects leech juice from a spider-infested cave near Hogwarts. But Deke hasn't heard from Tubbs in a while. As the item you wove in the loom has an enchantment that might be useful, Deke thought you could test it whilst checking on Tubbs. Tubbs cave shouldn't be terribly far from here.
Thanks for watching, Laser and Tell Your Friends!